happens. Other news right now, opponents of California's new transgender equality law say they have more than enough signatures to overturn it. But as KCRA3's Mike Lurie shows us, it is how they're getting this measure to the voter that's getting some attention.
Thousands of signed petitions still arriving today in the Sacramento Office of Privacy for All Students, the group that wants to overturn California's so-called school bathroom law.
This will be the first referendum in history that the majority of the signatures that were turned in were from volunteers out in the field. That shows how much passion around stopping this law there is.
Make sure that they're registered voter.
The faith-based effort from church volunteers across California was pivotal in collecting 620,000 signatures that must now be validated by California's 58 counties. They say they have more than enough petitions to put a referendum on the ballot next November. It's significant, according to KCRA3's political analyst Kevin Riggs, because most measures rely on paid petition gatherers, not volunteers, to get on the ballot.
It's a strong indication that there's a strong level of support at the grassroots level for getting rid of this law.
One of the key battlegrounds on this issue has been here in Manteca, where a transgender high school student is now concerned about what overturning this new law might mean for him.
If it does get overturned, then I'm scared that my school might not let me be who I am anymore, and that people everywhere, people in California are going to suffer because of this.
Ashton Lee came to the Capitol last summer to drop off petitions urging Governor Brown to sign the new law. He did. But now referendum supporters say that law goes too far.
There needs to be privacy for all students.
And so now it's a numbers game with 504,000 valid signatures needed to place the referendum on the ballot. In Sacramento, Mike Lurie, KCRA 3 News.
California counties have until November 21st to tally those signatures, then two more verifications coming in January, then March, and if the referendum qualifies, voters would weigh in next November.